Hello, advanced placement and drawing students. I am here to let you know what you're going to do today. This is actually my second attempt at this. The first one was really funny. It sounded like a chipmunk talking. So unfortunately, I have to re-record this. So, it's all done. Oh, well. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Just keep going. Today, what you're going to do is a number of things. Actually, two different things. Two different things. The advanced placement students... I started with painting last time. I'll start with you this time. The advanced placement students are going to be staying in the classroom, and you're going to be working on continuous line contour drawings. I have an example on the website for you today, so take a look at that. Remember, a continuous line contour drawing is where you use one continuous line and you never lift it up. You never lift it up. You're always looking at the object in front of you. And in this case, we're going to use our hands. And we're going to do maybe 6 or 7 different drawings today. You'll have one large piece of paper, and I'll have it set out for you. It'll be a toned piece of paper, so it's not just going to be white. And we'll have 3 different values of Conte crayons out for you. You'll have the sanguine, which is a red or a brownish color. You'll have black, and you'll have white. And so you're going to use those 3. Now, again, we're dealing with continuous line, so you're not going to be able to switch between back and forth. So one drawing will be done in black, one drawing will be done in sanguine, one drawing will be done in white, or they'll all be done in black, or they'll all be, you get the point, you can use whatever you want. Tomorrow what we're going to do is we're going to take another look at the critiquing, so just be ready for that. If you're not going to deal with just the hand, you're going to need to, well, you know, I know that Maya wants to deal with the entire figure, but I think for today what we'll do is we'll just focus in on the hand drawings. Simply because first hour you probably don't have somebody in here with you that you can have model for the hour. Unless of course you guys want to share one another and then you'll only get 3 or 4 drawings done, but you guys figure it out. Whatever you figure out is going to be fine. The thing I want you to be working on is how does your eye translate so that your hand can render it. And again, we're dealing with that single line. So however you go about it is going to be fine. So long as at the end of the hour, you've got a handful of drawings that are all on the same single piece of paper. You're not going to do 4 different drawings. We'll look at another example tomorrow or Monday to give you a better example as to what the finished product might look like. So that's that for you guys. Sit tight while I talk to the painting class. Painters, you are going to be working out in the hallways. And I will have let the office know and the entire staff will know that you're out in the hallways. What you're doing is this. You're taking your sketchbooks and pencils out and you're going to be looking at the idea of perspective. You're going to be looking at architecture. No rulers, just your sketchbooks. In fact, I wouldn't even think about filling the entire page of the sketchbook up because you're going to be dealing with thumbnails. All you're doing is gathering ideas. So starting on your picture plane, your piece of paper, you're going to draw out small figures, format boxes. That's what they're called, format boxes. And then you're going to start dealing with how does that room recede? How does that hallway recede? Now, one-point perspective can be boring. So my recommendation to you is to think about overlapping hallways. Hallways that lead into other hallways, maybe hallways that lead into classrooms, stairways that go up or down. Think about 2-point perspective, think about 3-point perspective. We're not dealing with rulers, so you need to be drawing what you see. Now, my recommendation for you is this. I know that sometimes when we sit down with our friends, we talk a little bit. You've got 5 drawings that you have to accomplish today, 5 thumbnails. It gives you 5 or 6 minutes per drawing. So I recommend that you stay away from one another, focus in on the drawings, get them done. They're not finished pieces. They don't have tons and tons of value. They have some, but you're not working on this finely rendered, finished piece of work. That's going to come later. We have a lot of steps before we get there, so we're just coming up with ideas right now. Your guest teacher will be wandering the halls looking for you and keeping an eye on you. And the one thing I ask is that you're back with about 5 minutes or so to spare so that you can do your generalization question. So you can end the hour with that question. And offhand, I don't know what it is, but it'll be on the website. So take a look at that. So for everybody, your goals are down below. Take a look at them. Write them down. AP, get started. Painting class, get your stuff out and get started. Like I said earlier, we're going to be dealing with the critique on Friday. So with Friday coming up, I would suggest go ahead and bring a snack in tomorrow for sure, because I'm a little disappointed no one's brought in snacks, or at least none to share. That's all I've got, folks. We'll see you on Friday when I get back. Any problems, questions, contact me, email me, call me. You know how to get a hold of me. Bye.